Hi, I'm Nick here with President Gary and Smith Freeman, our Director of Product Engineering, and I am super excited. I have not been this excited in a while because we are talking about one of our most ambitious projects that we've ever launched here, our new Ultra Evolution speakers. Gary, you want to give us a little frame up on what we're presenting today?
That's great, Nick, and I'm really, as you are, I'm very excited because, I've been involved with speakers my entire life. I mean, I wouldn't even say my entire adult life, my entire life from being a kid up until working in audio retail and then finally audio manufacturing. Smith as well, I'm older than Smith, but Smith, you're not that young anymore. And we've both devoted our lives to great sound and to speakers.
Absolutely.
And Ultra Evolution is the culmination of everything all of us at SVS have learned about how to create great sound from speakers. And it's our vision. From the day we started together, our vision was to create reference experiences that are within reach of a normal person. And I feel like this is one more step forward in creating something really referenced, truly groundbreaking, truly basically setting a new standard for speaker performance, but doing it in a price range that's within reach of a normal person. Do you agree with that?
Totally agree.
Now let's dive into that name a bit, Evolution, because we had a lot of conversations leading up to developing these products about what would really convey what's special about them. And so this term Evolution kind of has some different meanings to it. And maybe we can dive into that a little bit.
It does tie into the vision of SVS, which is we don't launch new products just for the sake of launching a new product. Like, it's not like, oh, so-and-so version 2, version 3, version 4, and you're like, what's exactly the difference? Oh, this one has titanium. I'm thinking of the iPhone right now. But this was a really massive step forward in terms of what we're doing, and to just say, these are the new Ultra Series speakers, seem like it wouldn't do them justice. But they are an evolution in the sense that they're a culmination of things we've been learning over the years. But we wanted to make sure that we gave them a sense or a halo of being really totally different than anything we've done before.
And that happens in a couple different ways. There's material science that I think we had some real breakthroughs in. There's cabinet architecture, even the alignment of the drivers and the way the cabinet is built from the inside. There's just so many stories going on with these speakers, and it's never been done before, this combination. So, when you're talking about evolution, I feel like that's really conveys sort of what we tried to accomplish here in terms of not just, bringing performance that has never existed anywhere close to its class and its price, but a level of technology and sophistication that I think is really groundbreaking.
Well, what we're hoping from the world is that these speakers get embraced not just as an evolution of SVS speakers or SVS speaker technology, but an evolution of what's possible in speakers anywhere near the price range. We wanted this to be groundbreaking for the world of speakers. I know that sounds a little bit self-important, but I can tell you we've been working on this a long time. We're very ambitious and looking for something, a truly real step forward in what is possible in reference speakers, both in terms of performance, but also the availability of it to, again, normal people.
So let's talk a little bit about the technology in these speakers, because the form factor alone is very interesting, and I think that warrants a little bit of explanation on what led up to it and what the benefits are of just the cabinet architecture on its own.
Smith and I were kicking around, what in terms of cabinet do we want to accomplish? I mean, the Ultra Series speakers actually had very groundbreaking cabinet designs for their time, and Smith and I talked about, what would be the next step forward, and he's been playing with the idea of time alignment of drivers, but also the idea of almost a point source orientation of the drivers. So Ultra Evolution towers, there's three separate tower models, deploy acoustically centered time alignment. And the bookshelf speakers also, and the center channel also deploy time alignment. Can you talk a little bit about what time alignment is, mm-hmm. but also acoustically centered time alignment?
Yeah, time alignment is the physical alignment of the acoustic center of each driver in space, such that when the sound is deployed from those drivers, that the sound arrives at your ears at the same time. And so it's literally the position of the drivers relative to each other and when the sound arrives at your ears.
And the reason for this is that the sound emanates from different parts of the driver depending on what the driver does. And so in order to make that sound arrive at your ear or your listening position at the same time, you need to do some bending of the cabinet. Where does the acoustic center come into play there?
So the acoustic centering is this idea that you have a single point source that the whole speaker is emanating from. And so we can look at the tweeter as kind of that starting point. And so the acoustic centering is, now we have mid-range drivers that are on either side of it, above and below. And so the acoustic center of those drivers is centered at the tweeter again. And then we keep expanding on that and go all the way to the bass drivers. And now the bass drivers are flanking above and below and also in the front and back. So the acoustic center of those drivers is also centered at the tweeter.
And what I hear from that, and tell me if I'm right about this, is a very rock solid image and soundstage. Mm-hmm. It's just absolutely convincing in ways that I've never heard any speaker do. Is that because of this acoustically centered time alignment?
That's absolutely one of the benefits. You get truly a uniform and defined acoustic point that the speaker emanates from across the entire frequency range.
It's an interesting combination of focus but also a big expansive sound.
That's
it's
right.
Really very cool and very convincing.